Good evening, everyone. Time for another member update. So let's start out with Bitcoin Cash. Crazy move going on here. You can see Bitcoin Cash has been a huge contributor to this market cap increase. We're at $160 billion. So if you remember, I've been covering the market cap, which had been bouncing. Cryptocurrency has been bouncing between $130 billion and $90 billion or so. I think it went all the way down to $70 billion at one point. It's been fluctuating under 100 and over 100. Now here's a big jump, $30 billion above that old top of $130 billion. So we're not that far from $200 billion. The biggest contributor of that is Bitcoin Cash, moving from a price of we had the split the beginning of August, and it actually ran over $1,000. It stabilized around $200 to $300. Now just today it's starting to make a move, and you can see it started at 300 and it's just boom all the way to 500. So you know, this is $8 billion market cap. So just Bitcoin Cash alone added roughly $3 billion or more to total cryptocurrency market cap. So tremendous move. Bitcoin still high at 42.73. Ethereum's over $300. You can see Bitcoin Cash at 522. Litecoin's at 44. And so if we do them by market cap, you can see Bitcoin is number one with 70.5 billion in market cap. I remember it wasn't too long ago when I was doing those videos, and Bitcoin was below 10 billion, and the entire market cap of all cryptocurrencies was about 13 billion. We're now 10 times that. So when we were at 100 billion, I said we could go to trillion, 10 times that. How long has it taken to go 10-fold? It's crazy. It can happen. It's happening. Now, it's not without a reaction from the powers that be. Here's the latest from Bitfinex. Bitfinex is going to bar U.S. customers from exchange trading. Now, Bitfinex is big. You can see here, if you look at the Bitcoin Cash volume here, Bitfinex is number one at $500 million. At $113 million, with Bittrex coming in number two at $100 million. So Bitfinex is number one in trading for Bitcoin Cash, and it's going to bar U.S. customers. Let's read this. Bitfinex, one of the largest cryptocurrency exchanges by volume, has announced it will no longer allow U.S. investors to purchase certain tokens on its exchange that may be at risk of running afoul with regulators. According to the company's latest announcement, Bitfinex will also be making other changes to its service, no longer accepting verification requests for U.S. individuals effective immediately. Further, in the next 90 days, it will gradually discontinue all services to U.S. customers. The exchange explained that the decision follows a recent investigation by U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission on how tokens issued by way of an initial coin offering, or ICO, may be considered securities. Quote, "We anticipate the regulatory landscape to become even more challenging in the future," the statement reads. Specifically, Bitfinex expects a tightened regulation will apply to all ERC-20 tokens issued by Ethereum blockchain, citing two tokens, EOS and SAN, as offerings that will no longer be available for U.S. customers to purchase. The company stated it will be suspending the trading of the two coins beginning 12 p.m. UTC on August 16th. The decision is a notable one, as it's the first sign that a major cryptocurrency exchange may take action to avoid repercussions of the SEC's recent guidance, which hinted trading services would need certain registrations to sell blockchain-based securities. According to CoinMarketCap data, Bitfinex now ranks the third largest exchange by trading volume with $331 million in activity over the last 24 hours. EOS and SAN account for $5.7 million and $1.9 million in the 24-hour trading, respectively. So there you go. U.S. authorities beginning the crackdown, and this, you know, this is to be expected. If there's any point of failure for the price of Bitcoin, not for Bitcoin itself, of course, but for the price of Bitcoin in U.S. dollars, it would be the exchanges, because they've you know, they are regulated because they are registered with the government, and if the government wants to shut them down, they can. If the government wanted to shut down Coinbase tomorrow, they could. So what does this mean? Well, we saw the same thing in China. Now, the Chinese spun it as they were just trying to make sure everything was fair and above board, and I don't think that's what it was. But nevertheless, what we saw in China was a tremendous surge in local Bitcoin action. And I think that that's something that you'd see here. I think there may be a short-term impact on price. I think that if serious regulations come into effect that limit the flow of U.S. dollars, fiat currency, into Bitcoin, that may be the beginning of the next big correction, which could be anywhere from 50 to 90%. 50% correction would take us down to 2,100. 90% correction would take us down to 400. Neither one of those is out of the question. But again, that would take some serious intervention by the government. Basically, I think it would take them just saying that no exchanges can accept dollars for Bitcoin, so you can't sell Bitcoin in dollars at all. And ultimately, I think that probably the price would rebound and go higher, just as it did after China pulled the same stunt. It's not going to work in the end. But let's look at this Jim Rickards article. The end is coming, but the end isn't here. And everyone at this point sounds like a broken record, whether it's people in the precious metals community, people in the cryptocurrency community, all the alternative community and economists have been saying the same thing. And you know the saying, stop clock is right twice a day. But still, I think the advice is still sound. Precious metals and cryptocurrencies. Let's read this Rickards article and talk about that. This is Rickards exposes the elite's plan to freeze the financial system. Today's complacent markets are faced with a number of potentially destabilizing shocks. Any one of them could potentially lead to another financial crisis. And the next crisis could see draconian measures by governments that most people are not prepared for today. You'll see what I mean in a moment. But first, what are the catalysts that could possibly trigger the next financial crisis? First off, a debt ceiling crisis is just over a month away. If the ceiling isn't raised by September 29th, the federal government is likely to default on at least some of its bills. If a deal isn't reached, it could rock markets and possibly trigger a major recession. Given Washington's current political paralysis and intense partisan infighting surrounding President Trump, it's far from certain that a deal will be reached. Second, despite some official comments over the weekend downplaying the odds of a war with North Korea, a shooting war remains a very real possibility. North Korea's Kim is determined to acquire nuclear weapons that can threaten the lower U.S. 48 states, and Trump is equally determined to prevent that from happening. Well, we know that's just a distraction. Third, a trade war between the U.S. and China seems imminent. Trump has backed off his campaign pledges to label China a currency manipulator, an unequal trading partner, but Trump and Bannon most recently have made it clear that they're in an economic war against China for who will be hegemon 25 years from now. China would likely retaliate, and that could ultimately result in a 10 to 20% maxi devaluation of the yuan, perhaps by early next year. That would likely cause a stock market rout. Since China devalued in August 2015, markets fell hundreds of points in single sessions, and that was much smaller devaluation, less than 2%. And if markets collapse from either of these scenarios, which is entirely possible, governments will move dramatically to contain the damage. In my book, The Road to Ruin, and he goes on to plug his book and talk about a Vonnegut quote. I'm going to skip that. Eventually, the entire financial system will be frozen solid and investors will have no access to their money. Some of my readers were skeptical of this scenario, but I researched it carefully and provided solid evidence that this plan is already in place. It's just not well understood. But the ICE-9 plan is now being put into practice. Consider a recent Reuters article that admitted elites would likely shut down the entire system when the next financial crisis strikes. The article claimed that the EU is considering actions that would temporarily prevent people from withdrawing money from banks and prevent bank runs. The desire is to prevent a bank run so that when a bank is in a critical situation, it's not pushed over the edge, said one source. Very few people are aware of these developments. They get a brief mention in the media, if they get mentioned at all, but people could be in for a shock when they try to get their money out of the bank during the next financial crisis. Think of it as a war on currency or a war on money. Even the skeptics can see how the entire financial system will be frozen solid in the next crisis. The only solution is to have physical gold and silver and banknotes in private storage. And, of course, cryptocurrencies, which I think Rickards has addressed in the past, but he's not talking about now. So he's talking about a market crash. Now, how likely is that? I think it's likely. Look at this chart here. This is a chart of Apple and Amazon. So if you remember, the last financial crisis was 2008-2009. You can see on this chart the financial crisis before that. Well, we had a recession in 2000, roughly here, and a recovery. But the big other financial crisis was back here during the dot-com bubble. And you can see that Amazon stock had a tremendous run and then kind of a crash, and then came back. Apple, not as much of a run, but was dead for a long time, and finally in 2004 it picked up. But you can see a key price here is $5 at midway through 2005. Both of them sitting at that $5 price, they're both sitting at 160 right now. That's a 32-fold return since 2005. So the question I would ask is, do you believe it, let's say this is a microcosm or a representative of the U.S. Do you believe that the value of these companies is 32 times what it was 12 years ago? Do you believe that the value of the United States is 32 times what it was 12 years ago? Do you believe that the value of our economy is 32-fold of what it was 12 years ago? Or perhaps do you believe that the amount of money that has been printed since the last financial crisis is roughly 32 times what it was? Actually, if we go to the bottom of the last financial crisis, we're looking at about a $10 price. So 16-fold money printing. I think it's the money printing, and it's not the value of the economy. So for that reason, and based on the chart, I think that a crash is fairly likely. So if we do get a crash, if we do get what Jim Rickards calls this ICE 9 scenario where they freeze everything, the big question is going to be, what's going to happen to gold and silver, and what's going to happen to cryptocurrencies? Now, I personally hope, I'm not sure that I believe, but I personally hope that there's going to be some type of nexus between the two. I've speculated in some cryptocurrencies that I thought may provide that nexus. So far, I haven't really seen any, but the idea is that people would be able to transition fairly smoothly to an alternative system if they decided to freeze the system. Just recently we had a power outage here. We have a backup generator, and Jennifer and I were, I can't remember if we were watching TV or what we were doing, but we saw the lights flash out, and then a few seconds later everything came back on, and that, of course, that was a backup generator kicking in. Everything was just the way it was before. There was just a little bit of downtime, maybe 20 or 30 seconds, and we stayed on generator power for 3 or 4 hours until the main power came back on. I think of that as kind of analogy, a backup system. Basically, having precious metals and cryptocurrencies, and as Jim Rickards says, some cash possibly held in a safe, although I'm not big on that simply because they can just call in the notes. But definitely cryptocurrencies and precious metals is sort of a backup system, a backup generator that will take you through to the next point where there's stability. I think if they do shutter the banks and shutter the system, it's not going to be very long before it's brought back online. depending on whether they decide to give haircuts to everyone or whether they decide to give haircuts to certain people, something like Cyprus, perhaps something like Greece. Something like that's going to happen, but if you have a backup system in place, and I'm pretty sure most of you already do, the transition hopefully will be very smooth, and we'll talk to you next time.